Lighthouse Baptist Church. We're glad you're here for your first time visiting. Good to see you. Good faces, smiling faces this morning, amen. I thought I was going to get out of the house this morning without a tie, but I got caught. So anyway, Donald, here I am. So as long as it works for Becky, it works for me. How hard to say that, Bill. Anyway, no, I'm blessed. All right, as the choir comes this morning, let's get to him. We'll turn to page 133. We'll sing the first and the last. Glory to his name as the choir comes this morning. One day, we're going to stand before the Lord.
Amen.
banking on somebody else's church membership, you're banking on your good works. You're banking on, well, I've never done anything that bad. Ain't no skills up there. He won't weigh out the good and the bad. He'll look for Christ in your heart. He's not there, you're doomed. You've doomed yourself, amen. He's here this morning. Amen. And he loves us very much. And his promises are true, amen. John 3:16 said, we'll never perish. Amen. Lord.
Amen. That's right.
All right. As the choir comes down, let's stand up and turn around and shake somebody's hand.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Amen.
My little great-grandson made me a bracelet.
Aww.
And sent it in a birthday card.
Aww. Amen.
Thank you, Casey.
Thank you. Amen.
I've told several people a joke, man. I tell everybody. Man come home, found his dog, looked like he was dead. So he picked him up, took him to the veterinarian. And he laid him down, and the veterinarian looked at it. Done a few tests on him. Then he went back in the back and got a big old cat. Brought him out there, ran him over the top of the dog, just kept running over. And he took the cat back. And he looked at the dog and he said, I don't think I can do anything for him. He's dead. And the man said, well, how much I owe you? He said, well, you owe me $500.
$500? What have I got to owe you that much?
He said, well, $100 for office visit and $400 for the Jets game. He didn't make it.
What you do? I'm singing, bro.
This is for you, Miss Shirley. Just what you want to
do. Amen. Bless her, Lord.
He counts the stars one and all. He knows how much sand is on the shores. He sees every sparrow that falls. He made the mountains and the seas. He's in control of everything, of all creatures great and small. Thank you. step that I take, every move that I make, every tear that I cry.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Woo-hoo!
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Brag on Jesus a minute. Everybody's got chapters in their life. Good, some not so good, but I reckon the things that bothered me in the last, I shouldn't, but the last 3 or 4 months, it's just blowing my tin up. I'm blessed to have Becky, and I'm blessed to have this new life. I'm blessed to have my church. Most of all, I'm blessed to have Jesus, because my heart just, it gets heavy down there when these precious people, they have their own concept about the house. And you see little things that Cindy did, and they're just thrown out the back door and thrown away. And that's just life.
Yeah.
And if she was here with me, she'd say that, Roger, that's just silly. That's material stuff. But, I just want to tell you, Jesus has been through me, with me through this whole journey. Suzanne, you know what I'm talking about. A lot of you know what I'm talking about. You've lost moms and dads and aunts and uncles and brothers and sisters. We've all got grief. Don't get me wrong. I'm not the only one here who's got that. But He's with us.
Yes.
And He comforts us.
Yes, He does.
You know what? He comforts me through a lot of times. You all.
Amen.
Your smiling faces. The things you say.
Mm-hmm.
Just your presence is big for me.
Yes.
And, but we will pray for one another. Amen. And just remember, when it gets too dark and your heart gets so broken, that's when He's there so close to you.
Amen. You better believe it. That's right.
And He's so faithful. It's so wonderful.
Yes.
And so true. I just want to praise the Lord.
Amen, brother.
All He's done for me, amen.
Amen. We love you, brother. Praise God.
I love you, church.
Amen. Appreciate you. Amen. Yes, thank you, Lord. Amen. Beautiful. Praise God.
This song is for those times where you really don't know what to say when you pray. And you're just thinking, gosh, Lord, just hear my heart. Mm-hmm. Hear those words. I laid on my altar a time or two, more than a time or two. Just laid my arms out and cried tears. Didn't really know what to say, but just cried.
That's right.
But He knew what I was crying about.
Yes, He did.
Amen.
He knows Him.
When you've lost a spouse, a loved one, when you're just hurting, when your marriage is having problems, I've been there. Even people in the ministry have problems too.
That's right.
That's right, amen. Yeah.
When your granddaughter can't find a word to a song in the morning. This song is for you guys.
Amen.
Sometimes I feel no one's been in this place before.
Yeah.
This is hard, and I'm not sure that I can do this anymore.
Yeah, think about it.
I know someday I'll look back, and all this won't seem real. But Lord, right now I need you. Just how I feel.
See our visitors with us today, amen, and just glad you could be a part of our service today here at Lighthouse Baptist Church, and most of all, we just want to magnify and we want to lift him up, amen, and want to give him honor. I hope today that you can see and you can feel the true love of God's love and his faithfulness to us, amen. How many of you know God's faithful,
amen?
He's faithful, amen. Yes, he is. Amen. Yeah. All right. Children, is the workers here for the children? Amen. All right. You can go back to the back, and if you'll meet Miss Siobhan back there, she's going to take you to children's church. Amen. All right. So we didn't have children's church last Sunday. I mean, God, you know, the Lord just took over. Amen. And we like that when that happens. Amen. The Lord just takes over, and we just praise the Lord for that. Amen. And we appreciate you being here and being a part of our service today. Amen. Good to have Lorraine's daddy with us today. Amen. Good to have him. Good to have all our visitors. Amen. It's good to see them here. Amen. If you will, I want you to turn your Bibles to Hosea. Now, if you find Daniel, it's one book from Daniel over Hosea. Hosea is a very short chapter. Well, it's 14 chapters, basically. But Hosea, there's a great story. As Hosea is the start of the minor prophets, Roger. And we talk about that. After Daniel, there's minor prophets. Obadiah, Joel, Amos. Hosea was the first. There's something here that we can learn through the book of Hosea. First of all, we can see God's true love and his faithfulness to Israel. Amen. And how many of you know that God's true love and faithfulness, even us to us as Gentiles, amen? Yes. Because God sent his son, Jesus. He was sent for the world, but the Bible says in Romans that he was sent to the Jew first.
Yep.
Because of his people, they rejected the Messiah. How many of you know that that gospel was passed down to the Samaritans and to the Gentiles, amen, in Acts chapter 10. Amen. Aren't you glad that we have a chance to be saved and be born again?
Yeah.
And let me just say, how many of you feel like today that God is living a story through you?
Glad.
Amen.
Yeah.
Just slip your hand up and say, I believe God's living a story through me. Amen. Well, let me tell you something. There's something about Hosea in the book of Hosea that God is using Hosea for an object lesson. Amen. It's very strange that we see the Word of God and we see a command that God gave Hosea. But I want you, will, if you will, stand to your feet if you find it. Hosea, and let's look at chapter 1 and let's look in verse 1 and just read a couple verses of Scripture. The Bible says, the Word of the Lord came unto Hosea, the son of Beer, in the days of Uzzah, Jotham, and Ahaz, and Hezekiah, king of Judah, and in the days of Jeroboam, the son of Josh, king of Israel, the beginning of the word of the Lord by Hosea. And the Lord said unto Hosea, listen to God's command unto Hosea. And he says, Hosea said, I want you to go, and I want you to take thee a wife of whoredoms, and of children of whoredoms. For the land hath committed great whoredom, departing from the Lord. So what did Hosea do? The Bible says, so he went and he took Gomer, the daughter of Bala, which conceived and bare a son. And the Lord said unto him, call his name Jezreel, for yet in a while I will avenge the blood of Jezreel upon the house of Jehu, and will cause to cease the kingdom of the house of Israel. And it came to pass at that day that in the break of that I will break the bow of Israel in the valley of Jezreel. Verse 6 says, and she conceived again and bare a daughter. And God said unto him, call her name Lo-Ruhamah, for I will no more have mercy upon the house of Israel, but I will utterly take them down. But I will have mercy upon the house of Judah, and I will save them by the Lord God, and I will save them by bow, nor by sword, nor by battle, by horses, nor by horsemen. Now when she had weaned Lo-Ruhamah, she conceived and bare a son. Then said God, call his name Lo-Ami, for ye are not my people, and I will not be your God. Let's pray with me right there. Father, Lord, in Jesus' name, I pray, Lord, I can never, Lord, preach this message, Father, on my own. But I pray, Heavenly Father, God, would you just empty me out, and God, fill me with your Holy Spirit. And I pray, God, as we look at the book of Hosea, God, we see warnings after warnings, Father, from the children of Israel, from Judah and the children of Israel, Father, how that they had once served you, they had once saw the miracles of God, and how they had left, and just now they were divided and they were in captivity. I mean, God, here was a sharp warning that you gave your people. God, even today, you're giving us a sharp warning that we must follow you. We must be disciples of you, Father. God, you gave us the greatest love of all when you gave us your Son, Jesus. And Lord, as we come by faith and we receive salvation by faith, and Lord, even then, we know, Father, that we're not perfect. But Father, we are a new creation in Christ Jesus through salvation, because the Bible says that we become the sons of God. But Lord, it's times after our salvation that, Father, we begin to walk away. Or God, we begin to become dull of hearing. And Father, we don't grow in our Christian walk. And Father, you have to send warnings and stark warnings sometimes to us. And God, I pray, may we obey the heed of the calling of God today. And God, we realize, Father, that we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. There's none righteous, no, not one. But God, help us as we look through the story of Hosea just for a few minutes. God, may you see, may we see a picture of love. May we see a picture of compassion. Father, we love you in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, you can be seated. As we look through the book of Hosea, it's a very strange command that God commanded Hosea. Said, Hosea said, I want you to go and take a woman of whoredom. In other words, he says, Hosea, I want you to go marry a harlot. I want you to go marry a harlot. Not only do I want you to go marry a harlot, but I want you to have children of whoredom. And basically they did. They had three children. The names of their children, we read, they're a little hard to speak. But the names of their children, and as we look at the Word of God, we've seen the names, and I'm in the wrong place. I got to get turned over. Amen. We see the stark warning here. One of them's name was Jezreel, the son, which meant judgment. That world that would come. Then he had a daughter named Lo-Ruhamah, which means no compassion. And then they had another son, which means Lo-Ami, the name. And basically it means not my people. But here, Hosea was a prophet for God. How many of you, I want us to get this clear today, that there's not a person in this world that God can't use.
That's right.
God has chosen you and I before the foundation of the world, Roger. God sent His Son. And that great love that Jesus had for us can change us. And how many of you know that we can live a story through the Lord Jesus Christ?
Yes.
You know what, Roger? My story, my life is a story.
Right, that's right.
Your life is a story. Our lives are story. And guess what? My story is different from yours. Right. What if our stories were all the same? It'd be a dull world, wouldn't it? Amen. But you have a story. I have a story. Hosea has a story. Let me just say, throughout the 14 chapters of Hosea, the warnings that God sent through an object lesson of Hosea, the children of Israel did not heed.
Right.
And I'm afraid today, through the preaching of the Word of God, and through the stark warning that God will call out to us, that there will be people that will not heed the warning.
That's right, that's right.
But God said one day, it's going to end. Yes. God said, I'm going to cut it off. But notice here, he told Hosea, he says, I want you to go and take a woman of whoredom. And he says, I want you to have children. And he did. They did that. Yep. Let's look here. Hosea, let's look at his love for his family was that when Gomer would leave to go after her lovers, that he would go and search for her time after time again. In other words, let me say what God was saying here was, the children, God, He worked through the children of Israel. Amen?
Yep.
In other words, He was the bridegroom and Israel was the bride.
Yep.
And He had saw how Israel had time after time, they had turned a deaf ear. I mean, God done parted the Red Sea for them. God let them march around Jericho, sent them to the Promised Land. God did all these great things for them. But yet, they still went and served Baal, some false god. Amen? Some false god. And today, even you and I, as a child of God, we can come into fellowship with God through salvation and be saved, or maybe not. Maybe there is, you know, the Bible says there's no other salvation besides the Lord Jesus Christ. In Acts, he tells about that. Neither is there salvation in any other. It's only through the Lord Jesus Christ. But God wants to, if you're not saved, let me say this, come to Him because He wants to live His story through you.
Yeah,
amen.
Right.
So we think about Gomer. And let's just put it in the everyday perspective. How would you feel to live with a woman or a mate or a husband, so to speak, that they're unfaithful?
Yeah.
I don't know you. That's not a good feeling, is it? So here, Hosea and Gomer had three children. And she would had a path to the world and to her lovers.
Yeah.
And she would choose that path.
Yeah.
And she would go out and be a harlot. There was Hosea. Hosea was left to change all the dirty diapers, wasn't he?
Yeah.
He was left to play the mama role, basically.
Yeah.
He was left to take them to the doctor when they needed to go to the doctor. Right. He was there to give them medicine when they had to have medicine. He was there to give them a breathing treatment when they had to have a breathing treatment, because Gomer was no more, she was nowhere around. But yet Hosea loved his wife.
Yeah.
He loved her. He loved her with all his heart. You know, what a hard job that must have been for Hosea.
Anyway.
As maybe she would come back home and she would maybe say, I'm going to do better. And then Hosea would wake up and the bed would be empty. And she found her path back out to the world and to her lovers. So God was picturing here that time and time again, how many times do you and I, we walk away from God? Time and time again. We walk, because actually, the Bible says there's none righteous, no, not one.
Right.
It says that if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us.
Right.
Amen?
Yep.
Just because we're saved, and listen, friends, we're sealed until the day of redemption, that does not give us a license to sin.
That's right.
Give me an amen right there.
Amen.
Amen. Because when you become a Christian, how many of you know you're a son of God? Amen?
Right.
And you're born into the family of God. You don't want to sin. Amen?
Right.
You want to take on the relationship with God.
Right.
Amen? But here, God chose to live a picture of love for His people through the love of Hosea. Imagine Hosea's heartbrokenness for his wife as she would leave to follow after her lovers.
Right.
And let me say, friends, Hosea gave her the very best. How many of you know God has gave us His very best?
Yes.
His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Shame on us.
Yes.
Shame on us when we walk away.
Yeah.
And when we get out of fellowship with God, as much as God has done for us,
yes,
to think that we would lose that first love, or
yes,
we would walk away. We don't lose it, but we walk away from that first love.
Yeah.
In Revelation, He said He had somewhat against them because they had left their first love.
That's right.
Shame on us.
Yeah, yeah.
But think about what Hosea was feeling about his wife. Somebody that he loved. Somebody that he married and he had children by.
Right.
And he wanted to make a good home for her. He made a good living. He provided for her. But yet she chose to go out into her lovers.
Yeah, yeah.
And to just forget about her husband and her three kids.
Right, right.
Think about that. Imagine his heartbreakingness. His heartbroken. He was heartbroken.
Yeah.
But how many of you know God's picture of love for us,
yeah,
is that we have the same actions as Gomer sometimes. Amen?
Right, right.
Number one, let's look at a few things here. Let's look at Hosea's obedience.
Right.
The Bible says that obedience is better than sacrifice.
That's right.
Now, I don't know, but I would have probably been a little hard-headed when God told me to do that. When God told me, said, Gary, I want you to go take a harlot, and I want you to marry her. I'm thinking, man, that's going to be trouble right off the bat. That's going to be trouble right off the bat. Amen. But let's look at his obedience. Hosea was obedient. He did what God told him to do. It was a picture. It was a story that God was working through Hosea.
Yep. Man.
Look here. How many of you know God was going to live an object lesson through Hosea? For Israel had turned to serve other gods. Think about how Hosea must have felt to love someone who was so unfaithful to him. I wonder how God feels today when we that come to Jesus through salvation, and we turn our backs. I wonder how God feels when we so choose to turn our backs on Him.
Right.
Let me just say that that don't change God's love.
Three.
That don't change God's faithfulness to us. Amen. Right. Because not only did it was us that walked away.
Right.
Amen. God didn't leave. No. God didn't go anywhere. He's still right there where you left Him.
Yeah,
amen.
Right.
Think about Hosea. Hosea loved. I believe he would put her in the bathtub when she came home. I believe he would scrub her down. I believe he would wash her hair. I believe he would bring them three children in. And I believe he would set them down. And I believe he would try to have family time at the house. And I believe he would try his best to say, I know that she's not going to do it again. This is going to be the end right here. I believe he would make the best supper that he could make. I believe he'd put some sweet tea on the table and made a meat and three vegetables, amen, and laid it out before Gomer. And the children, he had them all cleaned up. They wasn't snotty-nosed. He had them all cleaned up, and they just had a great meal, and he had a great time. I believe they reminisced of when each child was born.
Yeah.
But he would wake up the next morning, and nothing had changed. Gomer was gone.
Yeah.
She had found her path
right
back out to the world.
Yeah.
You know what? That didn't change Hosea's love for her.
That's right.
Though. We all have mates. Think about if they were unfaithful to you.
Yeah, come on.
How much pain and how much sorrow and how much hurt is that when they're unfaithful to you? That's not a very good feeling.
No, it's not.
But God is trying to teach us a spiritual lesson right here. Think about how Hosea must have felt. But yet Hosea's obedience to name his children, which meant what they meant. Hosea was left to care for his children. Number two, not only let's look at his obedience, let's look at how Hosea's endless love for Gomer was. If you look there in chapter 2, in verses 5 through 9, it says, for their mother had played the harlot. She conceived them and had done shamefully. For she said, I will go after my lovers, that my bread, that may give me bread and water, and my wool and flax, my oil and my drink. And therefore, he says, behold, I will hedge up the way with thorns and make a wall that she shall not find her paths. And she shall follow after her lovers, but she shall not overtake them and find them. Then shall she say, I will go and return to my first husband, for then was it better than with me now. But Gomer had not got that place. Verse 8 says, chapter 2 says, for she did not know that I gave her, listen to this, that I gave her corn and I gave her wine and oil and multiplied her silver and gold, which they prepared for Baal. Therefore, will I return and take away my corn into the time thereof, and mine wine in the season thereof, and I will recover my wool and my flax and give it to her to cover her nakedness. Time after time, Hosea would go in search for his wife and bring her back home. I believe he would. I believe he would find that path that she was taking to go to her lovers, and I believe he would search for her. But even that all that Hosea had done for her, it wasn't enough.
Right.
I mean, y'all knew it wasn't enough. To keep her from going back to her lovers. Number three, Hosea had to do something that hurt him very deeply.
Yes, he did. Come on, brother. Preach.
One day, Hosea had to say, enough is enough. You say, Will God ever say that? Yes, God can say that. Enough is enough. God will let Satan destroy the flesh, but he will save the spirit.
Right.
I'm going to tell you what, Hosea did something that was the hardest thing he ever did. There was a woman that he loved and had children by, but she seemed to choose her lovers over him. So one day, Hosea hedged the way where she couldn't find her way back home. She could not find her way home. Hosea hedged up her path for the way that would lead her back to Hosea and her children. How many of you know then she was left to be exposed by her lovers with no hope in sight?
Yeah, come on.
Think about that.
That's right.
She was left to be left with her lovers, the ones that she thought she wanted to be with. I wonder the conversations that probably Hosea had then. I wonder what Hosea told his children. I believe they sat down.
Yeah.
And I believe Hosea said, I don't know how long it'll be before I see my wife. Or I don't know how long it'll be before you see your mother. But I know one day it will be.
Yeah.
Sometimes we use excuse after excuse. How many of you know sooner or later God will hedge that up?
He will.
He'll cover the path. Yeah. I believe she got to a point one day, and I think I'll just go home. And she couldn't find her way.
Yeah.
Because her husband, somebody that loved her dearly, had hedged her way.
Yeah.
Hedged it up, and she couldn't find that path.
Right.
She couldn't find that path. She would then find herself not only exposed to her lovers, but she would find herself naked and emptied of all things.
Yep.
She would feel for the first time that no one is actually going to come
and
help me.
Right.
No one is going to come help me. Hosea's not coming. He's not going to. It's been days. It's been weeks. He's not going to come find me this time. My way is hedged up. I can't find my way back home.
That's sad.
But yet Hosea loved her.
Yeah, come on.
He loved her with an endless love.
Sure,
but that was one of the hardest things that he had to do.
Yeah.
Let me say, friends, God's love is endless to you and I.
Amen.
It is endless to you and I. God's love is endless, and His faithfulness is endless.
Yes, brother.
God is, He's love and He's faithful.
Yes.
In the back of his mind, Hosea's mind, he would probably tell his children, God will bring my wife and your mother back home. You know, that's God's desire today for you and I, that we would serve Him.
Yes, amen.
That we would serve Him no matter how the story's going.
That's right.
No matter how tough it is. No matter what it seems that we're facing, that we'll still keep our eyes on God.
Amen.
We'll keep our eyes on Jesus.
That's right.
And we won't choose to go back to the world, but we'll keep our eyes on God.
Yeah.
And we'll follow Him. That's God's desire for us.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen. How many of you know God uses messages? He uses people to get our attention.
Yeah.
He does. He gets our attention. But I believe, just think about the conversation that Hosea, he would have with his children. But in Hosea chapter 2, I want you to turn over with me to verse 14 through 17. He says, therefore, behold, he said, I will allure her. I will bring her into the wilderness and speak comfortably unto her. And I will give her her vineyards from thence and the valley of Achor for a door of hope. And she shall sing there as in the days of her youth and as in the day when she came up out of the land. And it shall be at that day, saith the Lord, that thou shalt call me Ish, and shalt call me no more Baal. For I will take away the names of Balaam out of her mouth, and they shall no more be remembered by their name. In other words, this was a very stark command that God had gave Hosea. Even through the 14 chapters here, the children of Israel chose to not accept the message of Hosea.
Yeah.
But here, Hosea, just like God, he has a plan. That if she could find her way back home, that he would receive her into their home again one day. Hosea loved her, says if she would just come and she would just knock on the door and I'd open the door and there she would be. Just hair all tangly, stinky, and rejected by her lovers. He said, I would open the door and I would receive her into myself.
Wow.
And I would restore her. And she would be my wife again. And she would be my children's mother again.
Right.
If she would just come home. It would be Hosea's love that he had for his wife that she would one day see.
Yeah.
I believe Hosea and the children, I believe at 9 in the morning, at lunch, they would get on their knees somewhere and they would pray. They would pray. Hosea would pray for his wife and the children would pray for their mother.
Amen.
That her eyes might be open and that she could for one time realize what she had left.
Yeah.
And what love was there at that home for her. I believe that was a daily conversation that they had. Until one day, when Hosea heard that his wife, Gomer, the woman of his children, was on an auction block. There she was, had sold herself out. As a harlot. Hosea heard that his wife was in the city and that she was on the auction block. And basically, she was going to be sold. She was going to be sold out to slavery. The woman that he loved. The woman that his children were by. You know what Hosea did? He took 30 pieces of silver. Basically, it was a half a year wages. A half a year wages and some barley. And he went into the city.
Sure did, brother.
And as he got there in the city, he saw the woman that he loved.
Yeah.
And it brought shame to him. They said that when they would put somebody on the auction block, they would strip them of their raiments.
Yep.
They were there naked.
Yep.
Because the buyers, they wanted to actually see what they were getting.
Yep.
How disgraceful and how shameful that must have been for Hosea. Somebody that he loved and had children with. And it's probably men and different people, they were bidding off. And they were bidding off. Let me say what Hosea did. He took everything that he had.
That's right.
He said, that's the woman
yep.
that I love.
Woo!
That's the woman
yep.
that God told me to marry.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's the woman that God told me to have children by.
Yeah.
And I believe he was weighted down with all of that silver. And he took it. It was all he could do to get it up there on that stage. And he put it on the stage. And the auction stopped.
Yeah.
Because nobody could match that. Hey. Nobody could offer more.
Come on.
And what Hosea had offered.
Right.
What a picture of love.
Amen.
What a picture of love. God loves me.
Yes, he does.
Yes.
I believe Hosea, I believe he picked her up.
Come on.
I believe he found something. First of all, probably to cover her nakedness.
Sure.
Where she couldn't be shameful anymore.
Right.
He picked her up. Yeah. I imagine they embraced and they loved each other. They hugged on each other. He carried her all the way home.
Amen.
I don't believe she had to make one step.
I believe
she carried her all the way home.
Amen, brother.
Think about that.
Yeah.
How in the world could that be? How in the world could somebody take somebody back that had been so unfaithful? You don't know my God.
That's right.
How in the world could God put up with me? How in the world can God put up with you?
That's right.
Because he loves us. Hallelujah. He's faithful to us.
Yeah.
He'll never leave us. He'll never forsake us. Hallelujah. Ain't that good?
Lord,
imagine they busted the door wide open. Busted that door wide open. Children. He began to call him by name, said, Mama's home. Yeah. Mama's home.
Yeah.
Wow, what a reunion.
Yeah.
What a reunion that must have been.
Glory to God.
You know what he did? He hedged that way. From the city to the house, he hedged that way. By this time, the path that she had been taken to the world was grown up. She couldn't find that path anymore.
Right.
Ain't that good?
Amen.
That's God's love.
Amen.
What a picture of God's love.
Yes.
Man, how that must have been that God would live a story through Hosea. But he did. And let me say this morning, God's living a story through you and through me today.
Yep.
Will we be faithful like Hosea? Will we be faithful and true like Hosea? That's my prayer that we will.
Amen,
we're going to close right here. Hosea took everything that he owned and he bought back his wife. I want to read something to you in Titus. You know what Hosea did? He redeemed his wife. He redeemed her. He bought her back. Let me tell you what Titus 2:14 says. Who gave himself for us.
Yes.
That he might redeem us.
Yes.
From all iniquity.
Amen.
You hear that? Who gave himself for us. That he might redeem us from all iniquity. And purify unto himself a peculiar people. And zealous of good works.
Amen.
Hosea redeemed the picture, the scene that day. Hosea standing there, seeing the woman he loved, was being shamed by everyone. But yet Hosea returns with her and restores her with her children. Yep. Let me say this. What Satan caused us to turn away from God, how many of you know God can restore it in you?
Amen.
God can restore it in you.
Yes.
And it can be better than it ever had been.
That's right.
Amen.
Stand to your feet this morning. I don't know why I preached this message. I was excited. I love this story of Hosea. I love it. Because it thinks about, I think about some tragedies that I've had in my life, Mama. and how that some hard times that I've had to go through. But yet it reminded me when I read this.
Yes.
That God's always, His love was always there.
Yes.
His faithfulness was always there.
Amen.
Oh yeah. I could have just threw in the towel. I said, I'm done. I'm quitting. But every time I would get to that point, I'd see God's love for me.
Yes.
That He gave. Mm-hmm. And that He redeemed me from all my sins.
Yes.
Because one day I was lost and on my way to a devil's hell.
Right. Me too.
But yet, God sending His Son Jesus,
yes,
He would redeem us.
Amen.
That if man would come,
right.
The Bible says, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Mm-hmm. Ain't that good? Ever have bound their right clothes? God knows your heart, and He knows my heart today. I've come to the conclusion that I'm a little hard-headed, and I'm a little stubborn when it comes to the spiritual things of God. But God has to teach me and has to give me a lesson over and over again. Let me say this. The Bible says that we've all sinned and come short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23, for there's none righteous, no, not one. Romans 5:12 says, wherefore is by one man sin entered into the world. And God told man, said, if you sin, you'll die. Ever since then, death has passed upon all men. And you know the wages of sin is death. But today the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Romans 5:8 says, but God commanded His love toward us.
Yeah.
And that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us.
Amen.
Romans 10:9 says that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised Him from the dead, thou shalt be saved.
Yes, yeah, praise God.
1 John chapter 1, the Bible says, if we say that we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we acknowledge our sins, let me say this, friends, that God said He's faithful and just to forgive you,
yes,
of your sins and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. Ain't that good?
Yes.
Why, every head's bowed and every eye closed. I wonder if there'd be one, two, three, say, preacher, I've never asked Jesus in my heart. I'm not a Christian. Would you slip your hand up and write that down? Say, preacher, pray for me. I'm not a Christian. I'm not going to come to you. I just want to pray for you. If you know that you're saved. Will you raise your hand? Say, preacher, I've been born again. Will you raise your hand? Say, I know that without a doubt. I've been saved. Come on back down. While Christians are praying, Sister Christine is going to play something on the piano. I want us, as we've taken inventory through the message today, how is your relationship with God? Have you walked away from Him? Maybe you've never asked Him to come in your heart. Let me invite you to come to the altar today. This is your invitation. You come. pass by. With me this morning. I want you to pray. I want you to pray after me. I want everybody to pray this. Dear Lord, I'm a sinner. And I need you.
I believe
that you died on the cross
to save me.
I ask you to come into my heart. And save me.
Forgive me of all my sins.
Cleanse me.
Make me whole.
Thank you, Jesus. For saving me. I wonder why every head's still bowed, every eye closed. If you prayed that for the very first time, would you slip your hand up and write that down? You prayed that for the very first time. Father, we love you today. Lord, I tried to be as obedient as I could, Father, to the message that you gave me today. Lord, we sounded the trumpet, sounded the warning. And Heavenly Father, we know that God, the Holy Spirit, has to do the rest. Father, I pray that we were challenged today, our hearts. Father, we were challenged to live. And Father, be faithful to you as Lord, you're faithful to us. Lord, we love you in Jesus' name. All right, you can lift your hands. All right, Michelle.
We have prayer cards up front. If you have a prayer request, go out the card, put it in the box. Prayer Warriors, pray for those on Wednesday nights. We have the mission star up front on the table. Anything you put in the mission star supports our 10 missionaries that we have. The monthly meal for this evening has been canceled, so that way it gives the choir time to practice our Christmas cantata. Roger, what time's choir practice?
5:00.
5:00. Be here 5:00. Be here 4:45. Even better. Please come out and support that. We've got a great cantata going on this year. I think everybody will enjoy it. December 3rd is when the church goes to volunteer at Operation Christmas Child. I currently have 20 spots available. If you're wanting to go, I need to know so I can get you signed up. Again, that's 20 spots that we have available. So 10 of us have signed up, so 20 more available. Let me know, and I can get you signed up for that. That will be on a Saturday. We'll be working from 4 p.m. to 10 p.m. Masks are not required this year. They are optional. They'll have masks there for anybody that prefers to wear a mask, but they're not required. Chick-fil-A will be on site that day. It says they'll have limited menu items available at peak eating times. Don't know what the peak eating times are. They didn't say that. So be sure to get with me, sign up for that. And then on December 4th, we're having our Thanksgiving / Christmas meal. The church is supplying the turkeys and the hams. We've already got volunteers to cook the turkeys. We need two volunteers to cook the hams. We've already got the hams purchased. We just need two people to volunteer to cook the hams. We also have a sign-up list up front for you to sign up for the side items that you're bringing, and also indicate how many people's coming so that way we know we have enough food for everybody. And then last December the 11th is when the church is going to Nearway Productions to watch the Christmas program. That is on a Sunday night. The program starts at 6:30. We need to be at Nearway Productions no later than 6 p.m. I think carpool last time, that worked great. If you purchased your tickets, or if you reserved your tickets, please be sure to get your payment into Slats as soon as possible so that can be taken care of. And then lastly, thank everybody that participated with Operation Christmas Child shoeboxes. Cindy got those delivered yesterday. Our goal was 150. We ended up getting 176 boxes this year.
Amen.
So that's
Amen.
Good.
God, that's good. 176. Amen.
And so with that, the shipping good. Of the boxes is $10 each. So we're asking each family of the church if they could donate $10 each to help go toward the shipping of the boxes.
Okay. Amen. Okay. We had mentioned Wednesday night. Some of you may not have been here, but they're needing pies. For the Christian Coalition, they're going to do 150 meals through the community, and they're going to do a Boston Bud, and then in a box will be the rest of everything they'll need for that Thursday for a Thanksgiving meal. And Brother Brandon King said he would like to have 150 pies, and some of you have already volunteered to do that. I heard there was some chocolate pies, and I know Siobhan's mother and them is going to be sending some, so think about the preacher too now, amen. But those have to be, if you want to make a pie or if you want to buy one, just the preacher said, we cheat, we'll buy one and wrap it up in tinfoil, take it out of the box. But anyway, they need to be at Anderson Grove Baptist Church by 5 o'clock tomorrow evening, okay, the pies. So if you want to donate some pies, I tell you what, the sweet shop has some good custards, you know. So anyway, they have to be there by 5 o'clock Monday. And then the meals will be distributed Wednesday. I think we've got to be there at 2 o'clock. And we have the opportunity to give meals around our community. And then we can follow up with them and be able to share Jesus with them. And then hopefully we can sponsor those for Christmas as well. So, great opportunity to serve, amen.
Amen.
Just endless ways to be hands and feet for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm excited about that.
What's the earliest you can take the pies?
Well, I would say if he says before 5, they should be, you know, anytime. I would say by lunchtime or after, you know, probably, yeah. I will check on that and make sure of that for you. Okay, because I don't want you to be standing outside holding pies. Amen. But what a blessing it is. Pray over that pie, and I tell you, there's also we've got a couple names down that we're going to have plates delivered to some of our elders. So be looking for a plate Wednesday evening, some of our elders, and we've already got your name down for that. So also they're going to do plates. All right. God is good. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for being here. Invite somebody. Please, choir, come and be a part of the choir practice. And I know God will bless you for that. And we love you. And don't forget about our monthly meal. We want everybody, visitors, everybody to take part of that with us. Amen.
Here, all right. I think the ones that came and finished up the boxes at night.
Amen. Yes.
Hard-working people.
Let's do one last thing. There's a family that me and the preacher is going to help in a little while. We're going to actually do a funeral. And we're going to pass the plate. If you are willing to help, maybe donate $1, $2, or whatever to them, I ask if you will to do that at this time. Okay? And so we're going to go and we're going to try to get a flyer. For them, and maybe some drinks. I'll get it right in a little bit.
Hey.
Now, the Southerner, now, if you live way down in the South, you say flyer.
Yeah.
But I think it's called flyer. But anyway, pray for us at 2 o'clock. We'll be doing that funeral. And then,
is this money helping on the funeral?
Yes. Okay, it'll be helping the family and be helping them. So you give generous as God has blessed you. Amen. And I know it'll be a blessing.
Thank you.
thank y'all so much for that. Thank God for a loving church, amen, and a giving church. Praise the Lord. The Lord will reward you, bless greatly for that, and we appreciate that. All right, let's close in prayer. Preacher, will you close us out? Okay.
Thank you, Lord. So good to Father, I pray that each one took at heart your word this morning. I'm so thankful that God gave everything. And because of that, I had a chance to get saved. And Father, be that one that may be lost. Take it. Put that their heart in your hands. That they can realize they need Jesus. We love you. Bring us back at the next point of time. In Jesus' name, amen.